it's always fun to make my arch rivals rank our goals. So I'm gonna start with like the United ones because Jesus, why not?
I can already imagine which goals you have on your list, man. This is bad.
It'll be against Arsenal and Liverpool only, bro. Like all five.
Yeah, let's see.
So wait, are we going to rank these goals by tribalism or by quality?
Tribalism.
That's a great question because like now we are getting into not so much of a quality discussion, the weight of the goal, the context of the goal, what it is. Since it's my club, what I'm going to do is I'm going to set the context. But for your clubs, when I'm pulling up your goals, I'd love to hear your thoughts around like the context of where you guys were in the season and just like talk us through the moment leading up to that goal.
Sure.
I will enjoy personally like setting the context for these goals, so I'm already loving it.
Jesus.
Cool. I know why you said this as the topic and like, you know.
I think what we should do, Sai? I think we can just, instead of blind ranking five United goals, we can just blind rank all eight goals United score against Arsenal in the 8-2 win and see which one's the best and which one's not.
I think today is not the day to make that joke. I might cry. Yeah.
And also, I'm not Sid or Vamsi to like gloat just yet. I will one day, but let's go. I'm actually composing a song for AJ for the day when United beat Arsenal. I'm gonna sing it on the pod. Like, you heard it here first.
I deserve it, bro. After last season, I would deserve it. So I'll be here to take it.
Yes, sir. So the first goal that I'm gonna show is actually Garnacho's goal against Fulham. This goal was especially like important, and I only picked like goals from the recent past, very recent past. Mm-hmm. But this was right before the international break. 1-1 would have like destroyed us because after this we went on to that really good run leading into the World Cup and after the World Cup to get a lot of points, and Rashford scoring season, everything kind of like triggered from this moment. And this goal was also like insane goal. I like Garnacho's goals because he gets into like good positions, doesn't really expend a lot of energy into the shots. But like, enough about the goal itself. What do you guys think?
Given the fact that it's not against my team and it did not impact my team in any way whatsoever, and that it only kind of contributed to a shot uptick in your fortunes after the international break, and at which point we already bet you 7-0. So taking all of that into context, I think again this goal's good. It's not that good. I really want to give it number one, but maybe I'll settle with number two.
And everything Abhinav said, plus the fact that it elongated the gift that is Erik ten Hag to rest of the team, let the rest of the league. So yes, number one, I would totally can advocate it to be the number one goal. I think it was game changer for the rest of the league because, you know.
You know what? I'm going to change it. The Ten Hag point, amazing. AJ, thank you so much. Yes, let's just move on. This is number one. This has the least impact on us, on Arsenal or Liverpool. We both agree. Ten Hag is still there. Good. Awesome. Move on.
Long way to continue.
Yep.
You heard it here first. Garnacho's like breakthrough season. Second goal, I think. First goal in the Premier League. Number 49 number is ranked as number one because it did not affect AJ or Abhinav's lives. And prolong the gift that is Erik ten Hag that has propagated through the WhatsApp channels of this world. And like, let the joy long may continue is the reason why it's number one, apparently.
Yes.
When I saw the Garnacho on the screen, I thought it was that overhead kick. I was like, okay, maybe
me too.
And then this came up, I'm like, okay, fine, this can go number one. It's very soft.
It is iconic. I didn't want to. That's the mystery in this, is because the goals are very subjective. You guys won't know what I put in there.
Yeah,
so you guys have to rank them as based on that. So next one, let's go. For my personal favorite, Abhinav, because I can't keep this out longer.
I can't watch it. Can I? No, please. Stop.
The context. Okay, the context in the alternate world is what I want to provide to the listeners today. A person from Austin, Texas, Abhinav, had flight tickets booked and then he was going to go to the FA Cup final. But this happened. I'm sorry, Abhinav. I have to do the big reveal today.
The tickets were for the Dublin final, which also kind of screwed me in a way. Doesn't matter. FA Cup was a long shot. We don't care about FA Cups. or Carabao Cups for that matter. But yes, continue. I can't watch it. I don't want to watch it.
Let's go.
Jesus fucking Christ. Fifth, man. Bro. JJ, I'm gonna fight tooth and nail with you on this. This is going fifth. You have no...
I didn't wanna torture you guys so much, so there are only three United goals. So it's only top three.
Because they don't score, bro. So I expected that. They had a negative goal difference.
No, dude.
And then this goal didn't do shit for the goal difference, by the way.
Bro, I think... there's still a possibility of an Arsenal or a goal against Arsenal. Actually, they never scored against Arsenal in the last few seasons. Fuck that. Right, put it on three.
How did... More than this goal, the Antony goal screws me up, man. Like, how did that guy score?
By the way, yeah. That's a great segue to the next goal, which is...
No.
It'll be Antony against Arsenal probably. 100. Because he has to put something against Arsenal.
Did we decide on this goal? What is the... We're all good, right? This is fifth or third, depending on how
this
many
is third.
Third, yeah.
I mean, just the amount of pain it caused you, I'll give it a third.
My friend in one of the other group, United fan, he still taunts me. Even when United was losing 3-0, he's still taunting me with this goal.
Jesus. Anyway. Okay, so it's settled now, but I still want to play this goal. This would have been my personal number one, but I just love this goal. Whenever we beat City, it's a nice feeling. And for all our struggles and everything, I feel like we've had that moment against our rivals. Unfortunately, Abhinav would also probably admit that we've been killjoys. We've been getting killed a lot in one of the fixtures, but like at least one fixture is when we'll come turn up as a killjoy, which is something that I take pride in. And this goal just sums it up. We had a counter, we had two shots, two really good chances that game, and we converted, and then we had a trophy in our hands.
I totally understand. I think again at this point I was drunk in Scotland somewhere watching the Celtic Red Rangers derby, whatever. Fun fact, right? I was really, after driving from Scotland, I was really wanting to kind of go to Manchester and look at the city and then just kind of drive back to Birmingham and London. The moment this happened, I took a detour, didn't even go to Manchester. I just wanted to visit the city for a bit and see how the thing is. I didn't even go to Manchester. I just kind of drove around and then went straight to Birmingham. So I cannot bear United fans at that point of time. But okay, coming back to the goal, I think the pass from Bruno Fernandes, or the flick, or the pass from Bruno before Kobe Mino, I think that was really amazing, man. I think Bruno, when he does things, when he's not losing possession, is an amazing, amazing footballer. As much as it pains for me to say it, but it's such a beautifully well-crafted goal.
Yeah.
I thought you were going to put Kobe's goal against Liverpool. He scored the second against Liverpool in the Premier League. That was a great goal.
I should start being more sadistic like our group members as well, because I don't know the expectations. I did not think this way, that only the Amad Diallo goal was that direction that I want to torture Abhinav a little bit, but I truly wanted to put iconic moments in my head. Let's do it.
That's what I'm saying. You're too pure, bro.
No, dude,
that's why you don't.
I just want
that
team to get better, bro.
yeah you're like a true football fan.
I think I am too scared of bantering, because I feel like I'll get owned more than anything, because I have nothing to show for my club is not doing that well. So I'm just resorting to peace and tranquility. I don't know if I'll be the same person if we are really good, though. That is the thing. I feel like there's a dark side inside me. When we get better, it might just come back to I might be an alternate Nirav personality or something, but I don't understand. I don't know that in my head. We'll find out someday. But
so basically, what you're saying is you could have actually gone for top five and tortured us more, but since you're Sai and you're being a nice person, you just went with top three.
Not really. I also, the other thing is that we didn't score a lot of goals in the last two seasons.
That's the truth.
That is the ultimate truth, to be very fair, because there were not really that many good goals. And also not really that many good goals in winning causes, which meant a lot. Not a bicycle kick over Everton, which was a 2-0, was the third goal in the game or something. So
yeah, I mean, not consequential goals, you would say.
Yeah, not consequential at all.